This is a Hewlett-Packard 107A on a cartridge. It's clearly a Samsung cartridge. It's a copy of the old Samsung ML1660 cartridge. On the top, there are two tabs. Their purpose appears to be to keep the cartridge locked in place. This cartridge has no screws. Instead of the screws, there are plastic rivets. Three on this side. Three on the other side. Two on the top. The compatible cartridges made in China may be slightly different. They could have screws instead of the rivets. Using a blade, cut the heads of the 8 plastic rivets. Be careful with the blade. I repeat, be careful with the blade. Hewlett-Packard obviously doesn't want you open the cartridge. Using the blade, remove the side panel. Note that on the bottom of the side cover there is a clip. It's not necessary to remove all the gears. However, take note of the position of the gears. Remove the other side panel. Remove the top cover. Separate the two parts of the cartridge. Slide the metal axle and remove the drum. The drum is probably reusable. Be careful to hold the drum so it does not become damaged. The light may damage the drum, so keep it in a dark place. Remove the charger roller with the supports. Remove the two screws of the wiper blade. Remove the wiper blade. Take the other part of the cartridge. Remove the toner roller with the gear. Remove the fill plug. Clean out all the remaining toner from the cartridge. It's better to use compressed air or a toner vacuum. The best you clean the cartridge, the best quality you'll have. Do not breathe the toner dust. Clean and inspect the felt seals. If they are compressed, rougen them up with a small screwdriver. Using a cotton swab, clean the toner roller blade so there is not evidence of build-up along the edge. If any build-up exists, the cartridge will streak. This blade controls the amount of toner on the toner roller. Be careful not to damage this Mylar sealing blade. Clean the toner roller with a soft cloth. You can use isopropyl alcohol too. The toner roller carries the toner from the supply chamber to the drum. The cleaning blade is probably reusable. Clean the blade with alcohol. lubricate the edge of the blade with toner. Clean the charger roller with water. The charger roller places the initial charge on the drum and erases the residual charge at the end of the print cycle. Replace the chip with a new one. Slide it in place. If you want to reuse the drum, look for wear, check for nicks, then clean the drum with isopropyl alcohol. For more information on how to clean a drum, in the description of this video, you'll find the link to a video on this topic. Reinstall the wiper blade with the two screws. Be careful not to damage the recovery blade that is located next to the wiper blade. If this blade is bent, the cartridge will leak. Install the charge roller in its proper position. Install the toner roller by inserting first the right shaft with the gear, and then the left side. Once in position, just press both ends until you hear a click. Fill the cartridge with toner. I think you can use a normal Samsung toner. Reinstall the plug. Lubricate the drum with toner, or the wiper blade may damage it. Install the drum. If you removed the axle, it has a keyed end. The keyed end is near the gear side. Insert the metal axle from the gear side. Turn the axle slowly while pushing. Join the two parts of the cartridge. Install the side end cap. Make sure the keyed end of the drum axle fits into the keyed hole in the cover. The end caps must be flat against the cartridge. Reduce the plastic rivets using a soldering iron or use some screws. And the work is done. For any problem with the cartridge, in the description of this video, you'll find a link to a troubleshooting guide.